Welcome to the Lesley University Library Instruction video series. In this video, we will discuss using keywords, and, or, and truncation to search the library databases for scholarly materials. One of the things we love most about Google is its flexibility. You can put whatever you want in the search box, whether it's a jumble of words or a full-on question, and Google will generally be able to infer what you mean and retrieve relevant results. Library databases are not that flexible. They require you to search in a very specific way. This may seem a little annoying, but the benefit is that the information you retrieve will be well worth the effort. Library databases work best when you do keyword searches. Keyword searching requires you to boil down your research question or topic to its most important nouns. For example, if my research question was, "What is the effect of media violence on children?" my keywords would be media, violence, and children. We'll talk about effect in a moment. Here's another research question. How do eating disorders affect a college student's academic performance? For this question, my keywords would be eating disorders, college, student, and academic performance. You'll notice they did not choose either effect in the first research question or affect in the second research question. I did not choose those keywords because the database will search for exactly what we put in the search box. That means a great article about media violence in children may be excluded from the search results just because it didn't have the word effect in it. You will generally want to avoid adding words like impact, benefit, pros, and cons to your keyword searches. This also means that you'll need to be flexible when choosing your keywords. Because the database searches for exactly what keywords you enter, you may need to change your search terms to either be broader or more specific. For example, if you did a search for just the keyword art, you could get way too many results. However, if you were more specific and used painting or sculpture, you could get results that better suited your topic. When searching library databases, you'll want to use AND to tie your keywords together. For example, in this research question, your keyword search would look like media, and, violence, and, children. The more ANDs you add to your keyword search, the narrower your results list will be. That means that searching for media, and, violence, and, children, and, urban will retrieve fewer results than just searching for media, and, violence, and, children. You can add as many ands and keywords to your searches as you would like, but if you start retrieving too few results, take something off and try again. Another trick for improving your keyword searches is to use OR. You want to use OR when you want to search for similar keywords. Let's look at the second research question again. The original keywords were eating disorders, and, college, and, student, and, academic performance. That's a pretty good keyword search as it is, but maybe you also want to search for articles about university students, not just college students. You could use OR to search for both at the same time. The keyword search would then look like this. Eating disorders and, open parenthesis, college or university, close parenthesis, and student and academic performance. You'll notice that I put the OR keywords into parentheses. A lot of databases will have an advanced search option, which allows you to change a drop-down menu from AND to OR. But if you have just a basic search box, using parentheses will help you and the database keep your search terms organized. Using OR in a keyword search will broaden your search, giving you more search results. The last keyword searching trick is using truncation. Truncation will help you to broaden your search to include various word endings and spelling. To use truncation, enter the root of a word and put the truncation symbol at the end. Most library databases use the asterisk or star as the truncation symbol, but Flow, Lesley's library catalog, uses the question mark. The database will then return results that include any ending of that root word. Here are some examples. If you're doing a search for a topic that included information about children, you could use child with an asterisk at the end, which would tell the database to search for child, childs, children, childhood, etc. Another way truncation can be useful is when you are retrieving articles about adolescents. If you put adolesce and then an asterisk, the database will retrieve articles about adolescents, as in a group of teenagers, or adolescents, as in the developmental stage of being a teenager. To review, you can use AND to narrow your searches, while you can use or truncation, to broaden your searches. You want to use a mix of ANDs, ORs, and truncations in your searches in order to retrieve the best results. Don't forget to be flexible with your keyword choices. And remember, if you need help, don't hesitate to ask a librarian.